layer. I do want to show something before we dive in and before I forget. When we're hopping forward from our downward facing dog, there's a couple things that can make this way easier. So from our down dog, when we hop forward, we use an inhale to lift through our tippy toes, through our hips. And then what I do is as I exhale, I step like, I don't know, 2 to 4 to 5 inches closer. And I go wide through my knees, kind of like a froggy squat. And I wait for that exhale, the out breath, to then hop. Right? Because if you step a little bit closer, you have less distance to travel, which means you don't need as much momentum, which means you're less likely to like overshoot the transition. And it always takes like a couple of tries to kind of find that sweet spot of how much push through your legs, how much engagement through your arms you need, how much engagement your finger pads are doing to help as brakes. But anyways, that is going to be kind of the foundation of what we're doing. And just remembering to give yourself that little step forward. Because a lot of what we're going to be doing is working through opening the shoulders and stabilizing through the shoulders, I wanted to start our practice with more of like a grounding meditation to find some balance before we dive into that. So let's go ahead and just start in either a seat or Shavasana. We'll be moving from the back body Shavasana eventually, but whatever feels most grounding in your body this morning. As you start to adjust and settle into your space, into your shape, taking a moment to scan through your body, to feel the places, the spaces of your body where you are in contact with the earth below. Closing down your eyes and tuning into those areas. Really feel the weight of your body settle into that support beneath. Your muscles, your bones become heavy. And start to breathe down into the earth below. Deepening every inhale. And starting to lengthen out each exhale. As we deepen each breath in, we'll start to slow down every exhale. Visualize your breath as reaching into the spaces of your body that are in contact with the earth. And visualize your breath creating roots from your body into the ground. From those roots, a sense of sturdiness, a sense of steadiness in your physical body. But then also results and translates into a sense of sturdiness and steadiness in the deeper layers of your heart and your mind. Every slow cycle of breath arriving you to this present moment. Into your practice, this time that you've decided to take out of your day to be in deep connection with your body and your breath. As you take a few more moments just to feel the earth beneath you, the quality of your breath. Your entire body. Also checking in to see if there is a personal intention that you'd like to set for your practice today. Whether that's a focus point or a dedication or devotion of your practice, your energy. bringing that intention forward. And as you do so, offering maybe one or both hands the space of your heart. We'll seal our intentions in with three rounds of cleansing breath. So with your next inhale, let it be particularly full and expansive. When you're ready, an open mouth exhale, release that breath out. And twice more like that, a deep, expansive inhale, filling up nice and wide. And a clearing, cleansing exhale out of your mouth, let it go. Just one more time, deep breath in, growing roots into the earth. An open mouth exhale to release any unnecessary tension from body, heart, and mind. As we shift into our Ujjayi breath, a deep inhale through your nose. Through your nose, a slow and steady exhale. Finding our way to Shavasana, if you're not already there, we're going to take a full body stretch. So, with a breath in, begin to reach your hands up and overhead. Find length through your entire body. And then, on your exhale, start to find some circles through your ankles and your wrists. Go really slow and really reach the full range of motion within your ankles and your wrists. Maybe 2 to 3 circles in each direction, taking your time, especially through the wrists, which we'll use a lot today. And after you've taken those circles, expand your fingers and toes as wide as you can, stretch through every digit, and then contract, gripping through your fingers and your toes. And twice more, an inhale, expand fingers and toes as wide as you can. And exhale to contract. One more time, breath in, stretch everything wide. The soles of your feet, the palms of your hands, and exhale, contract. And start to bring both of your knees into your chest, draw your thighs in close. Maybe a rock from side to side or some circling through your knees to start. And we'll find when you're moving pose, hands will interlace at the front of your right shin. Lengthen your left leg forward across your yoga mat. Let's make this nice and active, flexing forward through your left heel, draw your right thigh in. And then for a moment, see how it feels to release the grip of your hands and just use the strength of your core to pull your right thigh towards you. You might bring your hands back to your right shin for a moment, right thigh to torso, take an inhale. And supine twist as you exhale, release your right knee over to the left side. Settle your right shoulder back towards the earth. As you twist your heart open to the ceiling, take a really slow, expansive breath in. A slow and steady breath out. We're going to keep our right knee towards us as we roll to the back body again. And then reach your right leg to the sky for your hamstring stretch. So, deciding what feels best here, you can keep your left leg long, or you can bend your left knee and place your left foot to your yoga mat for a little less intensity. You can use your hands behind your right leg to bring your right leg towards your body, or you can use just the strength of your body. So, facilitated or unfacilitated hamstring stretch. And then point flex, take a couple rotations to your right ankle. With your breath in, flex your right heel to the sky. As you exhale, maybe encourage your right thigh a little bit closer to your body. Shoulders out of ears, take another breath in. And this time, as you exhale, releasing your hands if they're holding your leg, use your core to slow motion lower your right leg all the way down to your yoga mat. Navel pulls to spine, front ribs stay knit in as your right leg descends slow all the way to the earth. So you flex forward through your right heel, draw your left thigh in. Maybe start by using your hands on your left shin to gather your thigh to your body. And as you activate your core, what happens when you let go of your hands? Can you keep your left thigh pulled in tight, that strong compression? Maybe your hands catch your shin again as you take a deep breath into your belly. And use your exhale to release you into your supine twist, left knee to the right, left shoulder towards the earth. Maybe relax your right leg a little bit here, and as your bones get heavy, take a deep inhale. When you're ready, a slow exhale. Just like before, as you return to the back body, left leg will lengthen to the ceiling. Start to find your hamstring stretch of choice. And just choosing the option that feels good for you. Right leg long, right knee bent, hands or no hands. And maybe finding a little bit of movement through your left ankle. And just feeling how that movement in your left ankle trickles a sensation down the entire length of your left leg. Maybe you can even feel that stretch reaching into your low back, your hip. Your next inhalation, flex your left heel high and then use your exhalation to gently draw your left leg towards you. Think about rooting through your right leg to help bring your left thigh close. You'll release your hands from your left leg if you have that connection, breath in. And then using your strong core, slowly lower your left leg all the way down to your yoga mat. Just feeling the energy at your center as your left leg lowers. And from here, we'll bring both knees to our chest. We're gonna do just like one little core moment before we start to find our way up. Zipping your thighs together at center, reach your hands up and overhead like your full body stretch. And then navel to spine, front ribs in. As you inhale, you're gonna start to send your legs forward. So you can choose how much you extend and how low your legs go. It does not matter. You wanna make sure your low back stays firmly anchored to your yoga mat. As you exhale, you're gonna crunch everything up and in, lift your head, your shoulders. And as you reach forward to the front of your yoga mat, think about lifting your hips off of the ground, maybe trying to tap your nose towards your knees. And then we'll inhale, slowly reach everything long, navel to spine, low back, firmly grounded. Same thing, exhale, everything lifts, head, shoulders, and your hips, curling your thighs in as tight as you can. And for three, we inhale to lengthen, navel pulling down in that expansion. Exhale, contract, head, shoulders, and hips all lift. Last two, breath in, keep squeezing your inner thighs to the midline. Exhale, draw into center. Try to find that little lift of your hips away from the earth. Good, final round, inhale, everything stretches long, front ribs stay contained, trying not to flare them open, and then exhale, curl in, head, shoulders, and hips elevate. Then relax your head and shoulders down. Maybe take a modified happy baby. So hands to the fronts of your knees. Just let your knees fall open. Deep breath through your nose. And a cleansing open mouth exhale. Let it go. From here, we'll start to shift into our tabletop. So option for a couple rocks the length of your spine or however you'd like to find your way up to all fours today. And as you arrive into your table, top fingers spread nice and wide across the earth. And starting to warm up the wrists, you can shift a little bit forwards and backwards, or you might draw some circles over your wrists. And then shifting your hips towards your heels a little bit, or you might sit all the way back. You're gonna bring your fingertips to face your knees. And then start to create a stretch through your forearms. Rooting through your finger pads, feeling that stretch of the belly of your forearms. Take a breath in. And breath out. We'll find our way back into our traditional tabletop. Shoulders over wrists, hips over knees. And then go ahead and inhale to a cow pose. Lift your heart, lift your tailbone. Invite your heart forward and through. And then as you exhale, press and curl to find your cat pose. Be actively tucking through your chin as you drive the earth away through your hands. We'll make our way back into our tabletop pose and then tuck your toes underneath as you take a breath in. Use your exhale to float your knees off the ground into your hovering tabletop. So you push into the earth, that push lighting up your core, navel to spine. Take an inhale. As you exhale, can you draw your right knee towards your right armpit, as high into your armpit as you can? As you breathe in, right foot steps back, you're in your hovering tabletop. And exhale, second side, left knee is going to come forward into your left armpit as high as you can get it. Feel your strong core. Breath into your hovering tabletop. And exhale, downward facing dog, press your hips up and back. You can take a moment here, release and relax through your head as you find maybe some movement through your lower body. So a paddle through your feet, or option to lift your heels and windshield wiper your heels side to side, offering a side body stretch along your waistline. And then lifting your heels up high, take a little tippy toe step to the front of your yoga mat. Shifting your weight into your hands as you go, then release your heels to the earth and forward fold. Any movement here, any arm variations here, just taking a second to check back in with your hamstrings to release the length of your spine as you let your head fall towards the earth, completely relaxed through your neck. Breathe into the back of your body, and as you exhale, maybe soften a little bit closer to the earth and to your thighs. Your next inhale, start to find your halfway lift. Feel your core engage as you lengthen from crown to tailbone. Shoulders slide out of your ears. And exhale, forward fold, release. And take a deep breath in, circle sweeping all the way to stand, Urdhva Hastasana. And as you exhale, you're going to bend at your elbows. Your hands are going to hold on to opposite elbows. Let's do right forearm in front to start just so we can keep track. Shoulders are out of ears. Then slide your elbows back in space. Your head is peeking through that window of your forearms. Chin off chest. Take a breath in. Lift through the crown of your head. Lift through your elbows just slightly. Do exhale, side bend to the right. If you lean to the right, and your elbows move back, maybe peek underneath your left armpit for a moment, underneath your left elbow. Then inhale through your center. And exhale, side bend to the left. As you slide your elbows back in space, maybe look underneath your right elbow towards the sky. The breath in as you come back through center. Exhale, goddess arms, elbows open. Let your hands just fall to drape down beside your body. We'll take one big shoulder shrug back, maybe letting the elbows get involved. Really big shoulder shrug. And then circle sweep, Urdhva Hastasana, breath in. Soft knees, exhale to your forward fold. A half lift as we inhale, find length. And then high plank on your exhale, plant your hands and step your feet back. Your plank, finding your foundation, take a breath in. And then just like we did in our hovering tabletop, exhale, right knee towards your right armpit. Try to lift your thigh high into your chest. Inhale, high plank, right foot steps back. And exhale, second side, left knee up into your left armpit as high as you can get it, pressing through right toes and hands. Inhale, high plank. As you exhale, shift forward and lower slowly all the way to your belly. Once you meet your yoga mat, untuck your toes, bending your low cobra, light up along your spine as you lift your heart, and hover your hands deep. Breath in. On your exhale, draw your navel to your spine. Maintain the lift of your chest. Press down through your toenails, the tops of your feet. Take an extra inhalation. And then exhale to release. And we're going to shift into our Sphinx pose from here. So walking your elbows underneath your shoulders. Upper arm bones perpendicular to the earth forms two parallel lines. Press down through your palms, push through your forearms, and find a proud chest. Think about drawing your ribcage forward and through. As your collarbones press wide across your heart space, feel your shoulder blades draw towards each other. Crown of the head reaches to the sky. Nice big breath in. On your exhale, you're going to take your elbows wide, belly down, Shavasana. Stack your hands underneath your forehead. Take a breath down into your belly. You're going to keep your hands stacked in your forehead connected to the backs of your hands. We're going to lift that whole unit away from the earth. Yeah, so as you lift your chest, your hands, your head, you're still resting your forehead on the backs of your hands. Elbows press wide and tall. Think about pressing the back of your heart, the back of your skull to the ceiling. Strong along your spine, strong through your shoulders as your elbows lift. Take an extra breath in. And as you exhale, release. Hands will come back beside your rib cage. Press to a child's pose. Hips will shift to find your heels. And as you find your child's pose, pray your hands to the base of your skull. Bend at your elbows and bring the heels of your hands to the nape of your neck. As you anchor through your elbows, take a breath in. In your exhale, I can feel that connection, the rootedness to the earth from the beginning. When you're ready, making your way into downward facing dog, shift forward. Take your time to tuck your toes and lift your hips. Now in our downward facing dog, we're gonna inhale to our tippy toes, heels and hips lift high. Now on your exhale, think crouching, do a crouching tabletop. Bend your knees towards a hover. Keep pushing the earth away, hips pressing to your heels. As you inhale, lift your hips and heels high. On your exhale, walk a little bit closer. So maybe 2 to 4, maybe 6 inches closer, depending on what feels good. Breath in, bend your knees wide like a froggy stance. Look forward to the space between your pointer fingers. On your exhale, hop, or you can always just take a step from here to your forward fold. As you arrive to your forward fold, take an inhale to lift up halfway. And exhale to release. We'll rise to stand, big circle sweep, opening your shoulders as you go, Urdhva Hastasana. And then go ahead and bend at your elbows. Left forearm is going to go in front this time as you catch your elbows with your hands. And elbows are setting back in space. And this could be more like you're grabbing your forearms if elbows is a little bit have a sticky reach for you, especially this early in the morning. Elbows slide back. We're going to take a side bend towards the left. Okay. Think about chin off chest. Maybe peek underneath your right elbow. With your next in-breath, rise to center. And exhale, tip it to the right. Take a glance underneath your left elbow. When you're ready, a breath in brings you to center. Breath out to your goddess arms. Letting your hands fall and drape beside you. One big shoulder shrug. Letting the elbows lead the way. And we'll circle, sweep, Urdhva Hastasana, breath in. Your exhale, forward fold, hinging at your hips, dive down. Inhale to lift halfway, Ardha Uttanasana. And exhale to your high plank, plant your hands and step your feet back. Once you're in your plank, take your inhale. Just like we did before, exhale, right knee towards your right armpit, pull your thigh up and in, pushing through left toes and hands. High plank with your inhale, right foot steps back. Exhale, second side, left knee way up into your left armpit. High plank, breath in. On your exhale, shift forward. A chaturanga or a downward facing dog. So maybe moving from your high to your low plank into your up dog or your cobra. And then draw up and back downward facing dog. Take a cleansing breath to reset. Inhale through your nose. And then open mouth, exhale, let it go. And we'll inhale, heels and hips rise. Exhale, bending your knees into that crouching tabletop. Push through your hands, get low, strong core. This time, inhale, heels and hips lift. Step a little bit closer. As you exhale, knees go wide, froggy squat. Into your hopper, step to the front forward fold. Once you arrive, breath in to lift up halfway. And then this time, as we exhale, we're going to step our left foot to the back of our yoga mat, Anjaneyasana. Left knee lowers to the earth. We're going to be drawing a big circle. So our right arm is going to reach forward. Then we're going to take a big back stroke. And that's going to lift us up through an open arm twist to the right side of the room. And then keep it going into your exalted Anjaneyasana. So you're twisted to the right, left hand reaching to the sky. Right hand might find your low back or your left hamstring. Take a big breath in as you lift your rib cage off your pelvis. As you exhale, if you want to, you can bend at your left elbow. Left hand can go to the back of your skull. As you press your elbows wide, your collarbones wide, chin up, chest, finding a shoulder stretch to your left side, take a moment. We're gonna unwind from here. Frame your right foot on the earth and find your half split, Ardha Hanumanasana. So when you lengthen out your right leg, you might scooch your right foot forward a little bit, maybe grab yoga blocks, maybe use your fingertips. So adjust as needed and pull your right toes back towards you. Drag your right heel towards the back of your yoga mat. Use your next in-breath to extend your heart forward. And your exhale, just take a moment to settle. As we re-bend into our front knee, crawling your hands forward, lift your back knee off the ground, adjust. We're gonna be doing another kind of like whole windmill action here. So rotate your left heel down as if you're going to your warrior two. Then we're gonna rise up through our warrior two, but we're gonna keep it going to reverse triangle. Lengthen your right leg, reach your right hand up and back. Big breath in. With exhale, triangle pose, bumping your hips towards the back of the room. Reach forward first, reaching as far forward as you can. And then tick-tock through your arms. Your right hand can find your right shin bone, a block, or the earth. As you stretch your collarbones open, feel your front ribs draw in. Anchoring through your left foot, feel the back of your heart lean towards the wall behind you. We'll go through our warrior two to transition. Bend into your right knee, rise up tall with your breath. And then windmill your hands down into a low lunge to frame your right foot. Gentle standing splits, lean into your right foot, reach your left toes tall, take an inhale. As you exhale, chair pose, bend through your knees, your left foot meets your right. Once your hips are low, press through your feet, lift through your heart and hands. And then with your breath out, think about zipping your front ribs in, palms face center, and your hands can be as wide as feels best for your shoulders. But think palms in and try to lift your thumbs towards the sky, feeling the energy around your shoulder girdle. Give that one more inhale. Thumbs lifting, and then as you exhale, hands to heart. Shift your strength into your left foot. We're going to rise to stand with our right leg. So once you're in your one-legged mountain pose, hands can stay at heart, or you can catch your hands underneath your right thigh. So hands underneath your thigh is going to be a little bit more supported. Hands at heart, you're going to have way more quad engagement through your right side. So it's up to you. Chest stays proud either way. As we inhale, we're going to reach our right heel forward. Any amount of extension. This might be a small movement. That's okay. Exhale to bend. Core is strong to help keep your right thigh lifted. Drive through your left foot. Same thing. Inhale, right leg lengthens. Exhale to extend. One more time. Now, in particular, if your hands are at your heart, you really want to push through your left foot to extend through your right leg. And we'll meet in an airplane pose. Start to pendulum swing into your airplane. Hands might reach beside you. Okay, open through your chest. You can always use a little shoulder shrug to help create that openness at your heart. And then high crescent lunge, right toes step back. And inhale, sweeps your hands tall. And your exhale, bend at your elbows, right forearm goes in front as you grab your forearms or your elbows. Just to slide that arm unit back as you slide your rib cage through. Chin off chest, take a baby lean over to your left. Thinking about lifting your right elbow here for your inhale. So your left heel driving down to activate your left glute as you hold for exhale. We'll breathe back to center, both hands go high for a moment. On your breath out, hands to the earth to frame your left foot. Okay, step into your downward facing dog, left foot meets your right. With an inhale, heels and hips lift. Exhale, crouching tabletop, keep pushing through your hands and your toes as you get low. Inhale, down dog. Step a little bit closer as you exhale, froggy squat into your forward fold. Step or hop. A breath in will lengthen you halfway, Ardha Uttanasana. Use your exhale to step your right foot back, Anjaneyasana, low lunge. Release your right knee down to the ground. Now that you know the movement, it can be a little bit smoother. Breath in stretches your left hand forward to the front. Exhale, backstroke all the way into your exalted low crescent lunge. Okay. Twisting and a reverse as you turn to the left side of the room. Now you can stay right here, or you can bend at your right elbow. Maybe right hand holds your skull. Think about collarbones wide across your chest, elbows pressed back, chin off chest. One more moment. And then we're headed to our half split. So your hands windmill down to frame your left foot. Find length through your left leg. Again, adjusting as needed through your left foot, through your hands. Send energy and extension along the length of your spine as you take a deep breath in. With exhale, where can we soften? Where are we holding maybe unnecessary tension? Offering some ease to the space across your forehead, the space between your brows. Take one more breath here as you soften through your jaw. And allow your shoulders to release away from your ears. Start to find your way through your low lunge. Back knee is going to lift off the earth. Sitting your feet up as if you're going to your warrior two. Use your in-breath to rise through your warrior two, all the way into your reverse triangle. Lengthen through your entire left side body. Strong through your feet and inhale, maybe reach a little bit further. On your exhale, slow transition to Trikonasana triangle pose. Hips pull back as you stretch forward through your left arm. And then finding the triangle that feels good for you. Now, a way to find a little bit more right side or right oblique engagement is to take the back of your left hand on the inside of your left shin bone, and you're pressing into that as you root through your right foot, right? So your right foot and the push of your left hand into your left shin is gonna help light up your right side body. Breathing into warrior two, bend your left knee, wings spread wide. Exhale, windmill down through your standing splits. Lean into your left foot. Right toes sweep to the ceiling just for one breath in. Utkatasana, chair pose. Step your right foot down to the earth. As you find your strong seat, an inhale lifts you through your heart and hands. Now exhale, front ribs draw in. Maybe the seat goes a little bit further back and down. Again, your hands can be a little bit closer in, like you're holding a yoga block between them. If it feels better, hands can be wider, but palms to center, thumbs actively lifting to the sky. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Keep your front ribs zipped. Feel that heat through your shoulders for one more inhale. Then hands will find heart center with your exhale. Shift into your strong right leg. And then bring your left leg with you as you breathe in and stand tall. Okay. Relaxing through shoulders here. You can keep your hands at your heart. Again, that's going to be more left quad activation, or hands maybe wrap underneath your left thigh for a little added support. Pressing to your right foot, use that push to lengthen your left leg as you take that breath in. Try to stay tall and proud through your chest. Exhale, left knee bends. You can also just hold with your left knee bent. Two more breaths here. Maybe an inhale sends your left leg long. Exhale to bend. Last one, chest stays proud. Inhale, left leg lengthens. As you exhale, we'll meet in our airplane pose. Take your time to slowly swim back. Invitation for that little shoulder shrug to open your chest. Drive through your right foot, find buoyancy through your limbs with a breath in. Left leg activates. High crescent lunge. Strength of your right leg is going to deliver your left to be toes to the earth. Breathe your hands up high. Left forearm goes in front as you catch your forearms or your elbows. Shoulders are settled into the torso as you slide your ribcage forward and your elbows back. Slight lift of your chin off your chest. Take a baby side bend to the right. Left elbow tall towards the sky. One breath here. Feel your left thigh bone plug in and really drive through your right heel so both sides of your seat are engaged and active. We'll bring ourselves through center, hands reaching high for a moment before you bring your hands down to the earth. Step back into your downward facing dog. Right foot meets your left. Good breath in. And tabletop as you breathe out. And inhale, cow pose, heart and tailbone scoop tall. Exhale, cat pose, press and curl, tucking through chin and tailbone. Inhale, cow, heart and tailbone lift. And your exhale, puppy pose, anahatasana, keep your hips high. So you walk your hands out in front of you, bring your forehead or chest down towards the earth. Making this a nice and active stretch, pressing through your hands, whether you're on your fingertips or your palms. Please stretch your heart down to your yoga mat, your sternum to the earth for one more breath. As you push the earth away, walk back through your tabletop. We'll meet in our downward facing dog. We're gonna take one more little layer here, and then we'll see where we're at with time. So downward facing dog. Big push away of the earth. Arms are super strong, side body's long. Inhale, heels lift. Exhale, find that crouching tabletop, get low. Some inhale, heels, hips lift, walk a little bit closer. Exhale through your froggy squat into your forward fold, step or hop. You can always wait for a breath out. You can always take an extra inhale there. We'll halfway lift with our in breath. Step your left foot to the back of your yoga mat as you breathe out. Back knee might stay lifted this time. Otherwise, you can return your left knee to the earth like we did before. Reach your right hand forward as you take a breath. Drawing that big backstroke, we're gonna go through our open arm twist all the way into our exalted crescent. Keep it going. Left hand lifts to the sky as you twist your heart to the right. From here, unwind through your warrior two right away and reverse your triangle. Right leg goes long, right hand reaches, breath in. On your exhale, Trikonasana, triangle pose, lengthen forward, tip any amount. Inhale to your warrior two, right knee bends as your arms spread wide. Exhale, windmill down into your standing splits, lean into your right foot. For your breath in, left leg floats up. Exhale, chair pose, find your strong seat. Breathing in, stretch through your fingertips. Breath out, send your sitting bones back, zip your front ribs in, Find that active lift of your thumbs, keeping length through the nape of your neck. Really trying to isolate that energy to your shoulders. Can you reach your fingertips a little bit further? Think thumbs to the sky. Now, you can bring your hands to your heart like we did before, or you're going to bring your right forearm in front of your left. Hands hold forearms or elbows. Left foot stays on the earth. Bring your right leg with you as you stand tall. So again, if this arm variation is no longer working for your body, you can always bring hands to heart. Option to send your right leg forward as you take one breath. We'll fly back into this airplane variation with breath out. So whether you're clasping your forearms or your elbows, or you have a traditional airplane, or you could also go warrior three, hands just reaching to the front of the room overhead. Take one breath in. Exhale, high crescent, right toes release. And then goddess, your arms, elbows release. Use your elbows to find one of those big shoulder strikes. Let's take one more actually. So can I be like an ocean wave here? Sweeping forward, elbows lead, opening your chest. Hands will come to frame your left foot. Step back into your downward facing dog. Inhale through your nose. Open mouth, exhale, release. Just like we did before, inhale, heels and hips lift. Exhale, crouching tabletop, push the earth away as you sink your hips towards your heels. Breath in, lift up, step a little bit closer. Using an exhale, froggy squat to forward fold, step or hop. Now, whenever you're ready, half lift with your breath in. Use your exhale to step your right foot to the back of your yoga mat. Again, back knee can be lifted or grounded. And inhale is going to swim your left hand forward. Exhale, big wave motion, backstroke all the way into your exalted crescent. Activate your core to support that lift. Find a little extra buoyancy as you inhale. We're going to unravel through our warrior two into reverse triangle with our breath out. Feel your left side with an inhale. Trikonasana, your triangle, as you exhale. From your triangle pose, start to find your warrior two. Bend into your left knee, spread across your chest, stretch through your wings. Windmill down through your low lunge and into your standing split. Just one in breath to reach your right toes up. And exhale to your chair. So you find your chair, breath in, rise and reach. Exhale, front ribs zip, thumbs lift. Again, you can have your hands high, hands to heart, or left forearm goes in front, hands to your forearms or elbows, so you choose your variation. We'll shift into our right leg. With an in-breath, bring your left leg with you to standing. Settle, arrive, focus your gaze for stability. Option to find a moment of extension. Left leg goes forward as you take a breath in. Airplane variation is our exhale out. So again, maybe you still have your forearms over the crown of your head. It's going to be challenging for balance. So you can always release to your traditional airplane or warrior three. Take a breath in. Take your time. There's no rush. We'll meet in our high crescent lunge using an out breath to arrive. Right away, goddess, your arms. And then two big shoulder shrug, elbow circle wave situations. Traveling through your spine. Elbows driving the movement. Eventually, your hands come down to frame your right foot. Step back to your downward facing dog. Your down dog, inhale, lift your heels high. One more big push here, then we're in deep stretching. Exhale, down dog push-ups for three. So bend through your elbows and push. Two more, we're gonna bend and push. So you're essentially, you're in an incline push-up. One more if you have it, elbows bend and push. Then child's pose, knees to the earth, release your hips to your heels. It might feel nice to reach your hands back to your heels as you bring your forehead to your mat. Just let your shoulders round. Steadying your breath, take a slower inhale. An even slower exhale. And through your slow breath, inviting your heart rate to slow and steady. Your energy to steady. Maybe come back to the intention that you said at the very beginning of your practice. Take your time to eventually roll up to a seat. So think kind of cat spine up, back of the heart leading, maybe a shoulder shrug. Now go ahead and shift forward to the front of your yoga mat. Maybe grab a sip of water as you transition. We'll take Baddha Konasana, our seated butterfly. Soles of your feet will come together, knees go wide. The distance between your heels and your pelvis is up to you. You can always experiment here, closer in or a longer diamond shape. You can always adjust as you go. We'll sit up tall with a breath in. You can use your hands and your ankles to help invite your heart forward and pull your chest through. Maybe this feels good just to stay tall. If you'd like to go forward any amount, draw your heart forward. Maybe your hands release forward. Maybe allow the head and shoulders to melt towards your yoga mat. And you feel your entire body here in this moment. And breathing into the spaces of your body that are in contact with the earth. Breathing roots into those areas, finding a sense of stability and grounding once again. Take two more cycles of breath. If your body is requesting a little bit more time here in this shape, really honor that. No need to rush out. Otherwise, you'll lean back. Knees stay bent, hands can go behind you, fingertips facing whatever direction feels best for your body. We'll take a seated figure four, right ankle on left thigh. Flex your right ankle, press your right shin bone, your right thigh away from you, and then just take a little tip side to side. So you're actively pressing right leg forward into your left, and a little bit of side to side motion here. You can intensify this by bringing your heart closer to your shin bone. But really active through your right leg. And go ahead and just switch it out. Right foot releases down. Left ankle stacks on top. Flex your left ankle. Press your left thigh bone, shin, knee forward and away. Then find some side to side motion here. And you're just searching for any sweet spots of sensation. You can always pause in stillness if you find something that feels nice and juicy. And left foot will land to the earth, feet about hips distance, moving towards a reverse tabletop. This time your fingertips are going to face your seat. If you press your hands and feet into the earth, you can just puff your heart up high, lift your chin slightly, or you might also lift through your pelvis. Be shifting a little bit forwards and backwards in your reverse tabletop. Shoulders getting a nice deep stretch as you breathe in. Your exhale, hips lower to the earth. Flex your heels into the ground. trying to activate through your core, your hamstrings. Hands reach out in front of us, palms flipped to the ceiling. Take a nice breath in and use your strong core to slow motion descend down to your back body. Front ribs zip together, navel pulled back, heels grounded. Zipping up through the front line the whole journey down to the earth. Once you arrive, take a full body stretch, big breath in. And then just release your arms wide into a capital T. Let your arms be really heavy here. They did a lot. Your shoulders have done a lot. Using a little bit of core energy, bring your knees to your chest with an inhale. Exhale, knees tip to the left, gentle twist. Once your legs land towards the left, try to relax your legs as much as possible. We'll send two cycles of breath along the length of the right side body. Feel your right ribs expand with your inhale. And find some ease as you exhale. Slowly and gently start to migrate your legs to the opposite side. The right leg leads, left leg follows. Your legs will just eventually tip over to the right, gentle twist. You might allow your gaze to fall to the left. With your limbs heavy, and those two rounds of breath, breathing into your left side, directing your breath to your left side body. As we return to center, start to send our legs up to the sky. As your legs up, pose your waterfall. Take a moment and a breath here. An option to stay here, just feeling gravity anchor the back of your body to your yoga mat, feeling the reverse and the flow of the energy with your legs up to the sky, this inversion. Or if you'd like to shift into your plow or shoulder stand, feel free to send your legs either up to the sky for your shoulder stand or overhead to plow. Over the next 3 to 5 cycles of breath, be making our way into Shavasana. So in this space of these 3 to 5 breaths, take any final shapes, any final movements that your individual body is craving or requesting. Take whatever you need, or you always have the option to just go to Shavasana early. Give yourself a couple extra breaths to rest. You can always find a few windshield wipers or a cannonball moment before you go to Shavasana. If you'd like to draw your thighs in and curl your forehead or your nose up to your knees before you lengthen out. Whenever you're ready, you'll start to find your way into stillness. As you do so, allow your eyes to fall shut if that feels okay. Feel your breath reaching roots from your body down into your support, into the earth below. A sense of grounding washes over you. As you release any lingering tension, your head, neck, shoulders, hips, arms, and legs, all the way down to your fingers and toes. Your entire body steady and settled into this present moment. Gently begin to deepen your breath again. As you concentrate your attention, all of your awareness on the rise and fall of each inhale and each exhale. You can make the choice to either stay exactly as you are, continue to rest in your Shavasana, or maybe bring one or both hands back to your heart, just like you did when setting your intention for practice at the beginning of our time together. As you draw that intention or dedication, devotion back into the forefront of your awareness, back into your heart and mind. Take this final pause to pause in the deepest gratitude of this practice and deep appreciation of our bodies and our breath, all that we're capable of, and all that we receive from our time on our yoga mats. So, with gratitude in our hearts and our minds, we'll take one more deep inhale together. As you're ready, open mouth, exhale, release. May yoga offer us a path to compassion. May our practices always serve as our teachers, leading us to live with authenticity and to love deeply each and every day. Thank you so, so much for being here this morning. And namaste.